Hello everyone, it's me, Uncle John. Today I am going to read S3-3056. Pinky Dinky Doo, Back to School is Cool by Jim Jenkins. The summary of the story. When her little brother Tyler is nervous about his first day of school, Pinky Dinky Doo tells him a story about the time she and her friends had really bad hair days when school pictures were scheduled. This is my family. Mommy Doo, Daddy Doo, Mr. Guinea Pig, Tyler Doo, Pinky Dinky Doo, Daphne Toilet. These are my friends, Nicholas Biscuit, Bobby Boom. Woohoo! It was the first day back to school from summer break. Back to school rules, Pinky shouted. Back to school drools, Tyler said. Back to school is cool. Come on, little brother, time to get dressed, said Pinky. I'm not going, Tyler said. He pulled the covers over his head. You are too, said Pinky. I am not, said Tyler.
Thank you.
The answer was C, of course. I pledge allegiance to your hair. Wow, your hair has lift. Everybody decided to just get over it and make the best of a bad hairdo situation. They came out of hiding and took off the hat and hair cut out. Hey, I know that birdie. Then they marched to the gym where Mr. Pixel was waiting to take their school picture. Watch the birdie. And just as you might have guessed, that class picture was the funniest class picture ever taken. Now that's something you don't see every day. Nobody ever expected to end up laughing on a bad hair day, but they did, and nobody was apprehensive ever again. Poof, and that's exactly what happened, pretty much. Hey, that's the school bus, said Pinky. Oh no, Tyler said, I don't want to go on the bus. Come on, Tyler, Pinky said. You can sit next to me. We ride the big school bus together, remember? Oh yeah, Tyler said happily. Hurry up, said Pinky. I'll miss you. Last one on the bus has big bad hair. I bet you can make up a story too. The end. Hello everyone, it's me, Uncle John. Today I am going to read S3 3040, Miss Grub Super Sub by David Harrison. The day Mrs. Hood stayed home with the flu, Miss Grub came to Pittman School. The kids of 2B raised an awful fuss. They even made up a chant, Hoot, 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 we don't want a substitute. Miss Grub clapped her hands. I love your chant, she said. Then she made up a chant too. She beat on a book and yelled, Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and even in between. I love to eat pickle bits. I eat them till I'm green. The door opened. Mr. Tu, the principal, looked in and waved. Is everything all right? He asked. Miss Grub waved back. Perfect, she said. Now you can write a chant. Here is one to help you get started. Yummy, yummy, yummy. I love blank in my tummy. Morning, noon, and night, I gobble every bite. It's time for art, said Miss Grub. Everyone into the hall. Why? The children asked. Because that's where art is, Miss Grub answers. Miss Grub headed to the hall. The children followed. Art was the janitor. He was very busy. He emptied trash. He mopped the floor. He set up chairs. He cleaned the fountain. The class drew pictures of him while he worked. Miss Grub clapped. Very good, Art, Art, she said. Describe what your school janitor does. Draw a picture of one activity. Back in room 2B, Miss Grub called. Giggle break, knock knock, who's there? Said the class. Hoo hoo, said Miss Grub. Hoo hoo hoo, said the class. The room sounded like a barn full of owls. Everyone giggled. Miss Grub could use a little help with her jokes. Make up a joke of your own and write it down. Knock, knock, who's there? Hoo-hoo. Toad on a road. Why did the toad cross the road? To make a crossroad. It's time for recess, said Miss Grub. She handed out paper bags. These magic bags can hold wonderful things, she said. Miss Grub pointed to the sky. See that cloud? She said. That cloud goes into my bag. Hear that robin? His cheery song goes in too. The kids filled their magic bags with what they saw and heard and felt and smelled. Describe something special you'd put in your magic bag. Tell us why you chose it. Children at School of Love. I love my kids at school of love. Books. I love reading books. Jesus and Mother Mary. I love them so much. Now draw it. Miss Grubb had more surprises. How much mass do keys eat? She asked the class. Keys don't eat mass, they said. Mrs. Farmer, the cook, says you do. Said Miss Grubb, the class headed to the lunchroom. There's mass everywhere, Mrs. Farmer said. She showed them her weekly food list. I multiply and divide to decide how much to order. Menu, pizza, salad, apples, pudding, number of kids, 100 times $2, that makes $200. Another job is adding up the money, she said. If any is missing, then we have to subtract. The children left. We do eat a lot of mess. It was time for lunch. Mrs. Farmer's food tasted good. Miss Grubbs said quietly. She was writing in a journal. The students asked what she was writing. Wait and see, she said. Back in class, Miss Grubb read from her journal. Today at lunch, I heard the children's voices. Tonight, when I go to bed, I will remember the sound. It'll lull me to sleep. Pretend you are in Miss Grubb's class. What would you write in your journal about eating lunch at school? Want to meet a monster? Miss Grubb whispered. Where? The kids asked. Right on your hands, said Mrs. Tilling. It was the school nurse. Mrs. Tilling smiled. To meet a monster, look at your hand. She said that germs are monsters so small they can hide on skin. She showed everyone how to scrub their hands with soap and water. We don't want monsters hiding on you, she said. Think about Mrs. Tilling's germ monsters. Draw one the size of a gorilla, then finish this story. The day of the giant germ. One day, a giant germ walked into school. Kids yelled, yeah! Teachers yelled, yeah! Everyone was afraid. But this is what happened next. Blah, 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 blah. The giant germ was never seen again. Everyone said that blah, blah was a hero. Later, Miss Grubb promised to send all the students on their own special trip. Where would you like to go? She asked. Everyone shouted at once, the ocean, the mountains, the moon. No problem, said Miss Grubb. She took them to the library. The students told the librarian where they wanted to go. Mrs. Lairmore helped them find the perfect books to take them there. Miss Grubb winked. Won't Mrs. Hood be surprised at where you've been? Where would you like to take a special trip? Describe that place and explain why you want to go there. Draw a picture of it. Back in the classroom, Miss Grubb asked, can you crack my spelling code? She told the students to print their names on pieces of paper and to make the first letter big. When she called the students, they walked to the front of the room. They looked like this. I, Isabel, Larry, L, Oliver, O, Vera, V, Elaine, E, I love, Katie, K, IBI, David, D, Sandy, S, so I love kids. Can you crack Miss Grubb's code, fill in the blanks with the first letter of each child's name? What does it spell? Read it loud. At the end of the day, Miss Grubb and the class wrote notes to Mrs. Hood on the board. Welcome back, Mrs. Hood. I will never forget you, said Miss Grubb. I put your sweet faces into my magic bag. The kids all cheered. They made up a new chant. Grub, grub, grub. We love our super sub. We think you're super cool. Come back to Pittman School. Everyone agreed. It had been a perfect day. The end.